set mushroom and truffle pesto, which can be used basically to spread on ciabattas to make some like crostinis, and we can also do it with like a pasta dish, which we're going to do today. So we're just going to bind the pasta with the pesto and finish it with some capers, some fresh tarragon. So we've got the dried seps from Marks and Spencer. We've just soaked them just to soften them. 2 packets, boiling water straight from the kettle onto the mushrooms, let them soak, let all the juice come out. Toasted the almonds nice and softly in the oven, whole almonds, ground Padano parmesan, which is going to go in, clove of garlic, fresh garlic, some Marks and Spencer sea salt, some of the light olive oil, and then some of the truffle pesto, which is already in store. We're going to use that to add a truffle element to the mushroom flavour. Right, so it's going to take 1 clove of garlic. We're going to strain our seps, a couple of small handfuls of the toasted almonds, some of the parmesan. Don't need to grate it because we're gonna blend it all up to make a paste. So we've got the fresh garlic, parmesan and the nuts. With that, I'm just gonna put a little bit of the sea salt to get the seasoning started. Some olive oil, and what I'm gonna do with this, I'm gonna blend this first and then I'm gonna add the seps after. So I'm just gonna blend that quickly now. That's nicely blended now in the olive oil. So I'm just gonna spoon the seps into the blender jug. Truffle pesto. We're gonna blend that now. Nice sep mushroom and the truffle pesto. I'm gonna bind it into the pasta. Finish the pasta with some capers and tarragon and some fresh parmesan grated over the top. Marks and Spencer have got some awesome pastas in store. Messicani, Fiorelli, and they've got a really nice, this high fiber fusilloni. Today we're gonna go with the Fiorelli. Okay, they've also got really nice baked in-house ciabattas, so we'll probably make some like croutons to go with that as well, with the pesto spread on top. Just gonna make some ciabatta croutons. I mean, I love these. This ciabatta is like really good ciabatta from Marks and Spencer. So serve a couple of these on the side, just line them up in a little tray. Parmesan, a little bit of black pepper, and then they're just going to go in the oven 180 for about 7 minutes just to go crispy. Got a pan of salted water, Marks and Spencer olive oil, just drop a little bit of that in the water, a spoon of salt just to season up the water, give that a mix. Rapidly boiling water. In. 1 minute in, just give it a little stir just to make sure the pasta's not sticking. The olive oil in there, it helps, but if you just put the pasta in there and walk away and leave it, then the olive oil can't really do its job. That's going to take between 8 and 10 minutes, and I'm going to put my timer on and check it after 8. 8 minutes up, so I'm just going to get ready to drain my pasta, but in another pan, I'm just going to get some of this pesto. Good spoons of the sep and truffle pesto. Spread it in the pan a little bit. Pan's just warm, you can hear it sizzling a little bit. It's just a little bit warm. Give it a little shake. I don't want it totally dry, so I don't want to leave it long in there. I want some of the liquid. With the pesto, give it a little mix. You can see it's mixing nicely. Just give it a little stir. Sure, the pesto's mixed nicely all the way through. You don't want big chunks of the pesto, you want it to be nice and evenly mixed. Gonna pick some fresh tarragon. Lovely aniseed flavour. Again, fresh herbs, if you can get them, which you can. Gonna mix that together. That's ready to serve. We're gonna put it in the plate. It's a very no-nonsense dish. Fresh capers on, a little bit of acidity, a little grate, black pepper, and then parmesan again. Croutons, and just a couple of these nice ciabatta croutons on the side. Let's add a nice little crunch. Not forgetting some lovely extra virgin Greek olive oil just to finish off the dish. And that's perfect.